As you can imagine, there are numerous applications of optical flow. I just want to share with you a few of them here. The first is an interesting one, which is the optical mouse. You may or may not realize this, but your optical mouse has a complete computer vision system inside of it. It has a light source, which illuminates the surface that the mouse is sitting on. And then you have a camera here, which is a very low resolution camera, typically, say about 64 by 64 pixels. But the advantage is that with that low resolution, you can make the pixels really large and therefore very sensitive to light. And that enables you to then produce video at very high frame rate, thousands of frames per second. In these images are captured and then are compared with each other. That is, optical flow is computed using either the derivatives that we talked about or correlation. And that gives you the motion of the mouse from one frame to the next with respect to the surface that it's sitting on. That information is then used to control, say, for instance, the cursor on your computer screen. But here's another example. You have a camera being used for traffic monitoring. This is clearly a static, stationary camera looking down at a highway. We know the three-dimensional structure of the scene in terms of the orientation and the distance of the highway from the camera. And so you know the ground level, if you will. And therefore, when you compute the optical flow of a vehicle that's on the highway, just from that flow vector, you can estimate the speed of the vehicle. So that's what's being shown here in terms of miles per hour. And as you can imagine, this information can be used to flag cars or vehicles that are speeding, take a picture of the license plate, and send a ticket to your home for a moving violation. So this is widely used. Here's another interesting application of optical flow, which is essentially to try and increase the frame rate of a camera. So let's say that this is a sequence that's captured of a scene. It's actually using a drone or a plane. And so you're capturing these images in this finite frame rate. And so there's big jumps between the frames. If you want to now emulate a high-speed camera, that is, you need to create then images that lie in between the captured images. The way you would do that is to compute optical flow between two successive images and then create interpolated images in between that use the optical flow to figure out how points are moving as they go from one frame to the next frame. So that's what's being shown here. These are mostly interpolated frames, and you get this very smooth video. This is also used to create slow motion effects, say, for instance. This whole problem is called retiming. And then there's stabilization. Image stabilization is now available in pretty much any consumer camera, including your smartphone camera. Imagine that you take a video of a scene, you're walking and capturing the video at the same time, you would end up with a video that looks something like this, very shaky. And so what one can do, and this is done very often with consumer cameras, is that the optical flow is computed from frame to frame, and then you look for what is called the dominant flow, that is the way most points are moving. That usually corresponds to the motion of the background of the video, say for instance, the house at a distance here. Then that flow is compensated for to remove the shake of the camera. And so what you're left with is the remaining flow, the remaining objects and their motion in the video. So after you apply image stabilization, you end up with video that's a little bit smoother, stabilized video. Much easier to look at. And here is another example, which is face tracking. So you're actually computing the flow of points on a face, and this gives you a lot of information. You can see from this mesh that you're looking at right here, if every vertex on this mesh can be tracked from frame to frame, then you can figure out when this person is blinking, how the lips are moving, what the expression of the person is, and so on and so forth. These techniques are very widely used in the analysis of faces. And here is finally another example, which is the use of optical flow for gaming. This is just one of many examples right here, where the user has a video of himself, and in this video you have a virtual ball, which is the blue ball that's being shown right here. And now he can control the position or interact with this ball by making motions of various types. He's moving his hands, optical flow is being computed, and the optical flow vectors are being used to guide the ball and move it through space and time.